Thank you very much, Mr. Deputy Speaker, and it's a privilege to respond to what has been a very, very fine debate to mark the UN International Day for the Elimination of Racial Discrimination. And I fear, Mr. Deputy Speaker, that I have far too little time to respond to the range of different points that were made in this important debate, and I recognise the case that was made for us to mark this on a regular basis every year. But I do want to start by congratulating the Honourable Member for Warrington South and the Backbench Business Committee for securing the time on the floor of the House to debate this important matter. I thought that he made an exceptionally powerful speech, and I was delighted to hear his explanation as the former mayor of Warrington of the hospitable and tolerant nature of his home city, and the call that he made for peace and tolerance. There were a number of excellent speeches in this debate from my honourable friend, the member for Stirling, the honourable member for Bradford East, the honourable friend for Solihull, the honourable member for Dudley North, the honourable my honourable friend for Cheltenham, Worthing West, and then the honourable lady for Lanark and Hamilton East and Brent Central. And a number of common themes arose, Mr. Deputy Speaker. There was an iteration of the observation of the rise of extreme far-right and fascist views, which we can all agree have no place in our society. There was an observation about the prevalence of these views on social media, and I think a number of comments welcoming the online harms white paper that the government put out today, and I would encourage all honourable and right honourable members to write in with support for the approach that is taking. I thought that the words from my honourable friend for Stirling about from his one of his local imams about wanting a society that represents a bouquet of different flowers was particularly powerful. And I also recognise the point that was made about citizenship service and international citizenship services and the role that that can play in community engagement. In a powerful intervention from my opposite number this evening, she read out the names. Of course, there's a live debate about whether we should even dignify these people with names recorded for posterity in Hansard, but she made a very, very powerful speech, and I'm very jealous of her constituent, Raheem Stirling, and do also pay tribute to the exceptional work that he's doing and others are doing in the world of football. The 1960 Sharpeville massacre was what led to the establishment of this International Day, but yesterday, only yesterday, I was in Kigali, Rwanda, to mark the 25th anniversary of the 1994 genocide against the Tutsi, and it's upsetting and absolutely wrong that if we look across the world today, we continue to witness, since 1960, incidences of intolerance, of discrimination and violence on the basis of race, ethnicity, nationality. And in his speech, the Honourable Member for Warrington South also rightly mentions instances of religious hatred, because so fresh in our minds are these horrific cases in New Zealand and indeed in the synagogue in Pittsburgh. We all want to see cohesive communities, Mr. Speaker, across this country and in every country, in which every individual feels safe from discrimination and hate. And we all have a responsibility to fight racial discrimination and strengthen our communities. But as many have said in their observations, the governments have a specific and particular responsibility. The Prime Minister has made clear her determination to tackle racial discrimination from the very first day she took office. The racial disparities audit has revealed racial disparities in our country, and the work that it was highlighted will help to end those inequalities and injustices that members of ethnic minorities can face when they access public services and the jobs market. Every individual should be able to fulfil their potential through their enjoyment of equal rights, opportunities and responsibilities. And since 2017, Mr. Speaker, we've taken action in education, employment, health and criminal justice. Moving swiftly on, we have made also strides in terms of our international work, and the government is absolutely determined to root out racial discrimination both at home and abroad. And in conclusion, Mr. Speaker, I want to reassure all colleagues of the government's absolute commitment to the total elimination of racism, racial discrimination, xenophobia and related intolerance. This government will continue to tackle these issues both domestically and internationally. We're fully committed to building safe, strong and united communities.
Faisal Rashid. Thank you, Mr.